Hi, I'm Katie Miranda, and welcome to the Palestine Solidarity Telesummit. Today I'm here with author and journalist Alison Weir of the website If Americans Knew. Can you start by telling us a little bit more about yourself and about If Americans Knew? Like, what are the goals of the website?
Sure, I'd be glad to. Just my background, as maybe people already know, but I'm somebody who knew very little about this issue 14 or 15 years ago. Like most Americans, I really had never focused on it. I don't happen to be Jewish or Muslim or Arab, and I really was really basically uninformed about it, but sympathetic to Israel. Then when the Second Intifada began in fall of 2000 and I began to pay attention, I noticed the news coverage seemed very one-sided. When I looked into it more, using the internet and to try to discover what was actually going on, I discovered really excellent reports from the Palestinian media, from Israeli media, from international individuals who were there, and started to learn what was going on and to see how much was not being covered in the U.S. media. So after a few months, I was so disturbed and astonished at what I found, I decided to go over there as a freelance reporter in early 2001 and just travel around to see for myself what was going on. I went around Gaza and the West Bank, and when I came back, I started the organization If Americans Knew, just to get the information to the general public in a non-political, non-ideological way. Really very much my intention has been to a journalistic way, where basically I feel people have the right to know the facts as fully as possible, and that's what we try to give them. So we do that through the website, but we also have a lot of other activities. We do a number of reports. I write articles. I speak around the country. There's a whole team at If Americans Knew now. It's not just me, to use as many ways as we can to get information out to Americans about what's going on there, especially since we give so much money to Israel. The U.S. government gives Israel over $8 million per day. It's really closer to $10 million per day.
Wow.
And our government vetoes many resolutions on behalf of Israel. So Americans like myself, who think, well, it's, you know, that's such a sad issue, it's far away, it has nothing to do with me, are incorrect. We have a great deal to do with it, and it has a great deal to do with us. So that's one of the things we try to emphasize at If Americans Knew. We are very much responsible for Israeli activities, which unfortunately are many of them violate human rights and international law. So therefore, we are being connected. We are funding criminal activities, violent activities, oppressive activities, discriminatory activities. And as we know from blowback, if you are causing damage or harm to others, at some point you will be on the receiving end of damage or harm. So that's one of the reasons it's so important that Americans know we're connected to it and know what's actually going on there. Because I feel that all of us, when we know the fact, will not be happy with American policy. When voters decide on a policy, we can make a change in our governmental actions. But that won't happen, I feel, until and unless Americans really have the full information on that. In today's world, where it's really, you know, very much just one superpower right now, there are, you know, other very important factors, but that makes the U.S. extraordinarily important and American citizens potentially extremely important. We're sort of the sleeping giant in this issue. So even though there are people in Europe and Palestine, throughout the Middle East, in Israel, that are trying to bring change, we're the ones that have, I feel, the greatest potential to succeed in doing that. And that gives us the obligation to know about the issue and, I feel, to do something about it.